Hi everyone, my name is Jose Urias and I'm a marketing intern here with the College of Technology. I'm really excited to be sitting here at HCSS with everyone here. We have some great HCSS interns that are going to speak on their experiences here, their journey that took them to HCSS and what they see for their careers and everything like that. So I can't wait to get started with y'all. So first I'd like to go down the row and have everybody introduce themselves.
I am Catherine. I am a digital media senior emphasizing in gaming and simulation.
My name is Jared Woosley. I'm a senior at the University of Houston, majoring in digital media with an emphasis in motion media.
So my name is Sheila Tran, and I'm an HR major with a minor in psychology, and I'm also a senior at the University of Houston.
Awesome. And so guide us all through your journey. You know, how did you hear about the company? What stood out to you when you were considering working here? Catherine, we'll start with you.
So for me, I saw a lot of emails from Health Technology. So I see HCSS a lot. And when they had a video editor internship, and I looked up the company and I saw that they had a 14-time award-winning best companies in Texas to work with. And I kind of thought it was too good to be true. But I saw that they had a culture page. I actually kind of believed it when I started working here. Mm-hmm. Their culture is really good.
Awesome. Sherry?
Kind of the same as Catherine. Mm-hmm. Just seeing a lot of emails from the College of Technology, and they were hiring for a really large video editing project. Mm-hmm. And since that's kind of where my passions are, I wanted to just give it a shot. And I went ahead and applied. Didn't know much about the company, if I'm being honest. I just thought it was a cool opportunity. And then as I got hired and like let some of my friends know, they're like, what, that's a really cool company. And I started like looking it up and learning more about the culture. Mm-hmm. That intrigued me further.
Yeah. Shayla?
So I actually was job hunting on Indeed because I felt like I wasn't moving forward with my career in my previous job. So I found HCSS, and like you said, Catherine, the whole 14 times winner of the best company to work at Texas really caught my eye. I had asked my mentor in my sorority, like, oh, do you know anything about this company? And she actually has said she toured and met Winnie before, and she really encouraged me to apply and interview. So I think with a lot of like support from my friends, they were the reason that kind of pushed me forward to going on with the interview process here.
And so what would you say was the most important to you when looking for like your first job or internship?
So I guess for me, it was because digital media has such a broad skill set. Usually most jobs are, they require so much out of you, and then sometimes I feel like I don't meet the requirements. So I think that's the most important to me when I'm looking for an internship.
For me personally, when it came to looking for an internship, I wanted something that would help me develop and grow professionally, and what the listing for the job said, it fit all the check marks, and I saw myself growing.
Mine is pretty similar to yours as well. I really wanted to find an internship that allowed a lot of growth opportunities and a place where I can gain more skills that are usually involved in my career path. So looking at, like you said, the job description, I think it really fit what I was looking for within a talent acquisition internship. So that's why I chose HCSS.
How did your college experience and courses prepare you for the work that you're doing now in your current role?
So digital media actually has a set plan. So like how me and Jarrett said, we have emphasis. Mm-hmm. So his is more on the video production side. Mine's more on like gaming and simulation. So I do have some video production skills, but as well as working with simulations and app creation. So that actually helps me prepare for this video editing position because it's also graphic design and also helping out with the event coordinating as well.
I'm really excited.
Yeah.
Very similar to Catherine's. Our majors are, similar, even though we have different emphasis. Mm-hmm. Digital media does have its core, and yeah, so graphic design, all that comes into hand. All my video editing classes really helped out because without them, I'd be qualified at all for my position.
So for me, actually before I applied for the TA intern position, I actually had taken a class under talent management And under HR, there's a lot of branches where you could be more specialized in. So talent management and I guess the professor I had really inspired me to pursue something under talent acquisition and kind of understanding people and how they would play a role in the company.
And so like, what were your aspirations regarding what you really wanted to get? Because you did manage like, you know, wanting to get a better feel of like a talent management role. So like, how does that translate into your career, for example, what you want to do?
So I guess my career goal was to always become kind of like a head recruiter.
Mm-hmm.
So working here as a TA, I work for, basically I'm doing recruiting.
Mm-hmm.
So I have the hands-on experience. I get a lot of advice and tips from the full-time employees that I work with. And I think that really gave me more knowledge than what a class could teach me because it allowed me to be hands-on and actually do it myself.
And then Jared? How would you say like this position so far? How long have you been here, by the way?
I just had my 3 years.
Three years? Really?
Yeah.
So how do you envision your career like with the experience that you've gotten here? Do you see yourself here long-term? Do you see yourself different industry? Where do you see yourself going?
For sure, I see myself being here long-term.
Mm-hmm.
Coming into the company, I didn't really have like set direction in life.
Yeah.
My previous supervisor actually is the one who kind of helped me like in figuring out where my passions lied because that was something I struggled with. But I really enjoy the work that I do at the moment,
mm-hmm.
and I could see myself doing it for many years to come.
Yeah, that's great. Catherine?
So my original aspirations were to be an animator at a video game company.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of different from what HCSS is, but in terms of helping my aspirations grow, I think the video editing really helped because it made me realize that maybe I'm more fit for video editing animation rather than 3D modeling and video game animations.
And so like before getting any internship, right? Before this internship, what was your idea of what it would look like? Like, did you have said idea, did it meet your expectations of what this internship was going to look like?
For the most part, yes.
Mm-hmm.
So we use a program to animate our videos. I actually do like the work that I do here because it makes it easier and I get to learn a new skill.
So for me, I had like an idea that interns, you know, get coffee and things like that. And what I really enjoy like is that here as an intern, I feel like a full-time employee
mm-hmm.
sometimes in terms of like they give us a lot of responsibilities and we get to make choices that can help impact our careers and the company as well.
Mm-hmm.
So they really leave that up to us and give us that freedom.
I also thought an internship would be kind of more like strict and kind of stiff where we would have to show up in like our blazers and everything, but after coming here I realized that it was like really casual and very like welcoming and you're very free to express your thoughts and your ideas, and I think that's super important as an intern. You're kind of learning how to take initiative, how to work within a company, so having that responsibility really allows you to grow. So that's something I'm very like appreciative of, being able to have an internship here.
And so what's been your favorite memory or like activity that you've done here? Because I know you got a full blown basketball court, you got a track and field that you showed me, and exercise, the whole gym. You got a lot of stuff going on here.
I think my favorite memory was when we did the Amazing Race. And it was literally,
yeah.
basically all the interns, and we split up into two groups. And it was kind of like a scavenger hunt against the clock. And it got really competitive to the point where some interns were hopping fences and running and sweating. So I think it was a great team building experience. And I think it allowed me to really meet all the interns here that came out. And that's where I really met Catherine too.
Mm-hmm.
We were in the
yeah.
same group. It was just really funny watching our teammates run around.
Mm-hmm.
There's been a lot. I think one that sticks out to me the most is every year we have a Halloween game.
Mm-hmm.
And my first year here, it was in the office, and it was basically we were split into secret teams, and we had to eliminate the other team. We didn't know who they were because we all used aliases, but there's just like Nerf gun wars in the office every now and then, and it was pretty fun. Mm-hmm. I got to assassinate a few people.
Sounds like a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Same as Shayla, the Amazing Race as well, since we didn't have much events since coming back to the office, but Amazing Race was the best one. Seeing our, meeting other interns, seeing them compete against each other, even though I was kind of laid back about it. Or I was able to meet Shayla through the Amazing Race, because honestly, I'm kind of more of an introverted person.
Yeah.
So it was kind of difficult meeting all the interns, and so it was able to open a door for me to talk to all of them.
And so what advice would you give to, you know, interns, especially as we go into the new school year and everything like that? I know, like, for me, I always get anxious during like job fairs and things like that. So what advice would y'all give, and especially when like looking into companies that you're going to speak to and then you're going to potentially interview with?
Speaking from a recruiter side, I think you should be very honest with yourself, and then also be very confident in what you're talking about. I guess how I put it is, like, if you put on a face where it's not actually yourself and you actually get with this company, how can people know how to work with you if that's not actually how you are? So I think being true to yourself and showing the recruiters or people at job fairs, like, how your personality is, I think that would really help you with fitting in within the work culture and then actually getting your work done and getting help from everyone else.
My advice would be to just try. I received a lot of emails for internships, and I was just scared to apply to all of them. I just felt like I was not qualified or ready for them. And one day I was just like, eh, I'll try it. And I applied to this one. This is the first internship I applied for, and I got it. And I just, if I never tried, then I wouldn't be here.
I would just say value yourself a lot, because branching off of what Jarrett said, sometimes you feel like you don't meet the qualifications,
mm-hmm.
but sometimes companies like HCSS will value that and take that and teach you how to do the things that they want you to do.
Well, I think we can end on that note. I mean, thank you everybody again, Catherine, Jarrett, Shayla, for joining me today. Y'all have a good one.